Hi, I'm Kurt. I'm with Traverse Tool Company. What I'm going to talk about in this video is quick change tool posts. So you see three sizes here. They're also available in smaller sizes as well as bigger sizes. These are just the more common sizes that people use. First thing we need to do when selecting which one to use is determine the lathe swing or swing over bed, which is the same thing, on your lathe, the lathe that these are going to go on. An easy way to measure your swing over bed is to put a center in your tailstock and measure to the closest way. As you can see, I have 5 inches here. So the biggest workpiece I would be able to put into this lathe is 10 inches before it would hit my way. So I'm measuring 5 inches to the center. That would be the radius. I double that to get the diameter. That makes it 10 inches. And always round down, never up. If you round up, then it would be your workpiece would be hitting the ways. So once you have that, also called your lathe swing, then you can see which size quick change tool post you're going to need. Something else worth mentioning is on the bottom of all these things is included a T-nut. So this is not going to fit your lathe. None of them will by any of the brands. They're all too big. And the reason for that is because there's so many different size T-slots on so many different lathes that there's no way the manufacturers of these things can make one to fit every lathe. So they just make one that's oversized and know up front that you're going to have to put this in a milling machine and machine it down to fit the T-slot on your particular lathe. It's soft steel, so not a problem to machine it, but you will need a milling machine to do it with. Okay, so the only thing left to talk about in this particular video is the holder on these things. And we get some people sometimes, some of our customers, they'll have a smaller holder. So on this holder, it'll hold a half inch shank very nicely. Well, sometimes people buy a tool holder that has a shank on it that's bigger than half inch, let's say 5/8. So this one holds a 5/8. So can you just order this one that holds a 5/8 tool to fit on that one? Problem is, it's too big. So it doesn't lock on. It's just way too big for the tool post. So that presents a problem. And people order the wrong block that holds their tool, thinking that all they need to concentrate on is the fact that it holds a bigger tool and it'll fit, but it doesn't. Now they have to return it, and it's not a good thing. So here's the solution. Dorian is a name brand of a company that makes a tool holder that fits a huge tool. Speaking of huge tool, this one is 1 inch. So you can take a cutter, the shank of a cutter with a 1-inch shank on it and fit it in here, and it's made to go right onto this holder or onto this tool post that normally would have fit a maximum of 5/8. So if you get a bigger tool holder or cutting tool, just get the block in the Dorian brand. It'll tell you right in our catalog or on our website what size it'll fit, what size tool it'll fit, and it goes right on there. Okay, here's the problem though. You have to be careful because you want to make sure you get the right block for the tool post you have. So here's the way they work. These three are series 100, 200, and 300. That's the way some brands do them. We have a couple of brands that work this size out that way. There are some manufacturers that size them alphabetically. So this series 100 in another brand could be an AXA. The Series 200 in another brand might be a BXA. The Series 300 in another brand might be a CXA. So 100 is an AXA, 200 is a BXA, 300 is a CXA. If I had a 400 here, that would be a DXA. And that's the way it works. Well, Dorian is one of those manufacturers that sizes them alphabetically. So this is a BXA holder, which is why it fits on a Series 200 tool post. And there's the fit. You can see it locks right on there. It's solid. So they are interchangeable from one brand to another, even if they're called something different. But you have to make sure that you translate it from the series number to the letter with the XA after it. And it should work, but it's a little bit expensive, but it's a huge problem solver. The only other alternative might be to machine down the block. I wouldn't recommend that though, because it's going to make it weak. Or you could cut down the bigger shank to fit the smaller block. It's going to be hard though. The shanks on these cutters are pretty difficult to machine. You'll definitely need a carbide end mill to do that with, and some patience. It can be done, but the better idea in a long run is just to get another holder. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you found it helpful. I hope that it helps you to select the right size holder for your machine, and I hope it prevents you from having to return something that you ordered that was the wrong size. So remember to like and subscribe, and again, thank you for watching.